Hi, I'm John Supan. I'm an oyster specialist with the LSU Ag Center and the Louisiana Sea Grant Oyster Hatchery Director. And today we're here to make a video on how to make a drum nursery silo. Okay.
This is a shore-based nursery system that can be used to grow oysters, clams, and mussels, and scallops. It's built using 55-gallon plastic drums that are fitted out as a silo. We have a 5-horsepower pump running raw bay water through a manifold here behind me, and then it delivers water to the silos, enters through the bottom, upwells through the seed mass, and discharges into a ditch back out to the bay. And these silos can be used to rear, in this case, oyster seed for use in cage culture.
All right. Well, the reason why we call this a drum silo is because we make them out of a 55-gallon plastic drum. As you can see here, this is the silo, a finished product. It's got handles cut in it to be able to lift it up out. The bottom of the drum gets cut up in this fashion to be able to allow seawater to flow through it. This section of the silo will hold the seed oysters. It has a discharge here for the seawater to flow out. And it has a mesh bottom for the seed to be held in place during operation. What is the top of the drum becomes the base of the silo. As you can see here, that's the original top of the drum. We'll be cutting holes in it to put attachments on it to let seawater flow through, and also to allow seawater to drain out when we want to drain it. And the beauty of this is that this then nests into the silo like so, and forms a watertight seal to be able to flow seawater through the seed. If you're going to make a lot of these, it helps to have a template to cut out the bottom with. This is a circular piece of plywood. It's 21 inches in diameter, 10.5 inches in radius, and it has a crisscross pattern in it at 1.5 inches wide. So the first step to making a drum silo out of a drum is to set your template on the bottom of the drum, draw your outlines of the triangles that you're going to cut out. And it's helpful to do this as a first step because before you start cutting on the drum, it's a pretty solid unit to cut on. And this is one of the largest cuts you're going to make on the drum. After we've marked off the bottom of the drum with the four triangles with the black marker, we drill pilot holes to cut the sections out with a jigsaw. I'm using a 1/4-inch drill bit for that. And I'm doing it in all three corners of each triangle. Then I'll use the jigsaw, place it in the pilot hole, and just follow the lines that we drew on the bottom of the drum. Well, after I cut out my four triangles, I've got some shavings here attached to the edges here, and you could either use a sharp edge or a thumbnail to scrape it all off, or you can use a Dremel tool and just shave off all the shavings here. All right, the next cut to make is to cut out the top of the drum to make the base of the silo. So this is the top of the drum, and you'll notice on the side of the drum there's two reinforced ridges, and what we're going to do is make a cut right beneath the top uppermost ridge to begin the base. So I'm going to drill a pilot hole right here near the edge of that ridge. So what I've done is I've drawn a line at the bottom edge of this top ridge on the side of the drum to make it easy to see when I'm making my cut with the jigsaw. So I have shavings on the edge of my cuts here for both what is now the silo base and the what will be the edge of the silo. And I'm just going to use the Dremel tool again to cut off the shavings. To make the water intake for the base of the drum. We're going to need a length of 1.5 inch PVC pipe. Schedule 40 is fine. 6 inches long. I'm going to cut a piece here with the cutters. So now we have to cut two holes in the base of the silo to make a drain hole and a hole to for the intake for the seawater to flow through. So I'm gonna, and the orientation doesn't really matter on where you do it on what side, but they want to be directly apart from one another. So I'm gonna come up 4 inches from the bottom of the drum base and mark a dot here. And straight across 4 inches and make a mark here. And then I'm going to use the 2-inch hole saw with the drill to cut the holes. So after I've made my two holes, one's going to act as a drain line, and that's for the for a drain hole, and that's for the number 11 stopper to be placed in here. And on this side, what we've done, instead of using a uniseal, we've sandwiched an 1.5 inch coupling to an 1.5 inch female adapter with a short piece of 1.5 inch pipe and glued it together and then fitted the male barbed adapter in here to make a seawater connection to the bottom of the base. Okay, one of the next cuts we need to make on the silo is we need a 1-inch piece of plastic ring to put on the inside as a retaining ring for the mesh that we're going to mount to the bottom of the silo. So I'm going to use this angle tool here and a Sharpie black marker, and I'm just going to scribe a line to follow with, so I can cut it with the jigsaw. I'm going to drill a hole in the line to start a pilot hole for the jigsaw. We need to cut in some handles now to be able to lift the silo out of the base. What we're going to do is measure down the side 2 inches, make a mark, and then we're going to make another mark 4 inches down so that the handle will be 2 inches wide. And then we're going to make the handle 4.5 inches long. So I'm going to center this at 4.5 inches. And make marks to cut in the handles. So make a mark there and then another mark at 4.5 inches. And then I'm just going to kind of square up some lines here to follow for the jigsaw. Going to drill a pile of hole in the four corners. And cut out the handles. Come directly across from the other handle you just cut, and then you can use the piece that you cut out. Come 2 inches down and use it as a template to draw your lines for the next one. Drill your four pilot holes. And cut it out with the jigsaw. And then you can use your Dremel tool to take off all your shavings. Today, the silo I'm building is going to be using 1/4 inch mesh. This is plastic extruded webbing that you can buy at hardware stores or at aquaculture supply companies online. And you're going to want to cut a circular piece, irregardless of what mesh size, about 1 inch wider than your template, so it can come up the side walls of the silo, and that'll help keep the seed from washing out from underneath it. Well, as you can see that I'm placing this in there, I'm trying to center it so that you get equal amounts of mesh on each side going up the walls of the silo. So this is the 1-inch ring that we cut off the top of the drum silo to make a retaining ring for the mesh to hold the seed in. So I'm just going to make a cut right here to be able to work that ring. So I've been mounting the retaining ring onto the mesh along the wall of the silo to hold the mesh in place. And right here, as you work this mesh up the side wall, you start getting these little puckers here. So I'm just going to reach in here with a pair of scissors and snip this. So when I put that ring on top of there, that mesh will lay flat. Now, since this is a solid piece of plastic, it's difficult to get in there and lay it flush, because as you can see here, it wants to fold up. It gets a twist in it. So what you've got to do is just kind of work ahead of yourself and get it to where it lay flat on the wall as best as you can. Put a screw in it and then go back and put another screw behind it to get this part to lay flat later on. So right here I'm gonna put in a screw. So I'm gonna go back and put another screw right in the middle of these two to flatten that out. All right, so I've got the ring mounted almost all the way around the inside of the drum silo now, and I'm getting pretty close to the end. And as you can see, you're going to have more than you need on the plastic ring. So when you get close to the end, you got to lay this flat and then make a mark and cut off that excess so it'll lie flush with the end right here. And then I'm going to reach in there with the jigsaw and cut that extra plastic off. And when I'm done, and after I lay this flat along on the edge, this will line up and make a nice flat joint along the side there. So we use a number 6 by 3/4 inch long stainless steel screw called a pan head screw to mount the ring on the inside of the drum silo to retain the mesh along the wall. And the screws are extra long for the job, so I'm going to use a Dremel tool with a cutting wheel on it here, and I'm going to trim off all these edges of the points of the screws so we don't create a lot of meat hooks when we're handling this thing. But as you can see, I've got some excess mesh on the upper part of the retaining ring here. I'm going to use the same cutting tool at a slower speed and just cut that extra mesh off. The last cut to make on the silo is to put in a drain so the seawater can flow out over the seed. So we're going to do this perpendicular to the axis of the handle. I'm going to make a mark 6 inches down from the top. And this is a 2.5 inch hole saw to accommodate a 2 inch PVC pipe. And then I've got a 2 inch long piece of 2 inch pipe and the two inch couplings. And I'm going to glue all this together and sandwich the couplings on the inside and outside. Give it a good twist, and that's your drain. Well, one of the last steps in fabricating a nursery silo out of a 55-gallon drum is to seal the edge of the retaining ring to the mesh along the wall of the drum to keep small seed from falling and getting trapped between the retaining ring and the wall of the drum. So what we're now that we've trimmed off the excess plastic mesh, we're going to reach in there and put a nice thick bead of silicone glue all around the edge of the retaining ring. Well, one of the features of having a shore-based nursery system is to be able to custom make your own seed oysters. Typically, when you purchase oyster seed from a nursery or from a from a hatchery, you'll start out with very small seed. And small seed don't need as much room as larger seed does, as such as in a drum silo. But you can use a drum silo system to accommodate smaller seed. One of the easiest ways of doing that is making what we call a pipe silo. This is some 8-inch sewer line pipe with no holes in it that we can cut to length, any length you want. This particular silo is cut for seed oysters so they don't wash out of the system. This is 14 inches long, 8-inch diameter pipe. And it's pretty simple to make. What we do is we'll cut the pipe to 14 inches long, and we'll, in this case, we're going to be purchasing seed from a nursery that stays on a window screen. So when that comes in, you can make a window screen silo, pipe silo, by draping the pipe with some window screen, preferably the plastic kind, not the metal kind, and then you get a large hose clamp that'll fit over top of your pipe. And what you do is you pull the screen tight as you tighten the hose clamp to get drum-like effect on the screen. And then before you do so, you wipe the edge of the pipe with acetone to get all your fingerprints and body oils off of it and get it clean. And then you can use some standard fiberglass resin. You mix up a small batch of it. I like to use these flux brushes that are used in the welding supply industry. And you put a nice thick bead of that silk resin all the way around the edge of the pipe. And after it sets up, you can loosen your hose clamp, and of course the screen will be glued or resin to the edge of the pipe, and then you can trim it with your Dremel tool with the drum sander on it and trim off the excess screen and resin using the same tool you might have used to take the shavings off the drum silo when you were cutting it with the jigsaw. So you get a nice smooth edge, fairly tight screen. You also make a 2-inch hole to set in a, this is called a uniseal, an 1.5-inch uniseal to accommodate 1.5-inch pipe. So you have a through wall effect like this. And the value of this silo is that you can use a standard 2-inch by 1.5-inch adapter and plug it into your discharge, 2-inch discharge of your drum silo, and then plug this pipe silo into that. And what you'll be able to do is use your drum silo as a nursery for your smaller seed with the pipe silo inside. And then as the seed grows and they become larger, you can take them out of the drum silo, take them out of the pipe silo, and then drop them into your drum silo if your mesh size is appropriate for that size seed. And it's just an easy way to accommodate small seed in your system.